So our food at Bill's Gourmet is sizzle sourced. We're using just sizzle menus and local suppliers. The style of the food at Bill's Gourmet is modern British with Italian twist. And we always try to build strong relationships with our suppliers and wholesalers. So my position at Bill's Gourmet is the head chef and polite dictator. I'm working for Bill's Gourmet for 3 years now. I think the Bill's Gourmet was established 14 years ago, so we got quite a long history. Our team at Bill's Gourmet is quite young, but experienced. We all work together. We got 5 full-time chefs, but in a busy season, we go around 15 people in the kitchen. So what's special about the malam for me is the marbling of the flap in the lamb. It's really tender, it's really nice color, it's easy to cook. If I compare the lamb meat and to beef, it's almost like Wagyu lamb. So at the moment, we don't use tamar lamb on our menus. It was for the first time when I was doing this competition, actually cooking with this product. I find it really easy to cook, so in the future, we might be potentially thinking about using tamar lamb on our menu. I heard about the competition, actually saw it in Staff Canteen Instagram, and I saw the post competition tamar lamb win trip to New Zealand, so it was the reason why I entered basically. So this tamar lamb competition was my first national competition, so for the first time I actually won, so I'm really happy about it. But before I entered a few local competitions from our local suppliers, basically just based on the Dorset, and I won already 3 local competitions. The inspiration for my dish came from my country, from Czech Republic, from the Czech Republic cuisine, and it's actually based from my grandpa's dish. It's like old school stew, I would say. So this dish is duo of lamb. Tamar lamb. It's sweet saddle of lamb loin and braised lamb rump. It's served with English punch carrot, confit heritage carrots, lamb bum. It's almost like brioche but made with lamb fat. Also, it's served with sheep's milk yogurt and carrot tops pesto. I think I win the tamar challenge because I was well prepared. I tried the dish lots of times. And also I kind of try to use whole parts of the cuts. So on a day, what I would change would be give myself more time for plating because in the end of the competition, I almost get caught with the timings. So my advice for the chefs, get more time for plate your food. So what I think about the price, about the trip to New Zealand, it was always my dream to go to New Zealand, so I'm really excited. Also, I can't wait actually meet all the chefs which are basically coming to the trip from all over the world.